Oh god. Oh my goodness. Oh. Pussies want me early. Then I round the corner every morning, look in the mirror, and I'm like a fucking founding father. Hey, we love it though. Alright everybody, oh wait, no, that was too much. Alright, how the hell do I start a YouTube video? What's going on? What's cracking like it? Ah! I am deep in the trenches right now. I got my period yesterday and it's been just a nasty one. So we're here, but I can't believe it. I am so excited. I'm so, I gotta throw myself a little party. It's a party. I am so just happy to have this space, and I can't wait to bring to you my whole heart and soul to be here as a friend for you guys. As you guys know, I struggle with making friends. We all need a friend right now, and that's my biggest thing, is to come on here and you guys feel like you're hanging out with a friend every day, because that's what I'm doing every single week. But, all right, obviously, big, let's like put the lights on here because we got a name change in this bitch. So you guys know my name on Instagram, or if you're new here, my name is College Clean Eating. So a little backstory on that, I started College Clean Eating when I was just in college. But I started College Clean Eating because I've always loved nutrition. I used to run healthy eating camps for elementary school kids when I was in high school. That was a huge project I did every single summer for Girl Scouts. Shout out to my fellow Girl Scouts. I started the account because I wanted to help other kids in college find affordable healthy meals. I wanted to share my journey. I was just getting into fitness and I was just trying to be a healthier, stronger version of myself. And while the journey with College Clean Eating was so beautiful, now I'm getting emotional. While it was so beautiful and it's such, the name is so meaningful to me because it's brought me so much. It's brought me so many good connections. It's brought me the most amazing community I could ever imagine building with Sculpt You. So while the journey was so beautiful with College Clean Eating, I really struggled with my body image. I really struggled with my relationship with food and myself during that time. And I also struggled heavily when I started getting into bikini competitions and I was struggling with an eating disorder. That's a really hard topic. Let me go back. Okay. And I don't relate to the words clean eating anymore. I don't relate to that portion of my life. And I feel like I'm just in a completely different mindset when it comes to food, nutrition, and training, as well as myself. So I just am so excited. And it's such a big thing for me because this has been, College Clean Eating has been the name now that I've had online and as a presence for years, probably over 5 years now. But I feel so more than ready to make that switch into a brand new name, as I feel like it's really showcases, you know, who I'm stepping into, and that name is Keeping It Katrina, which is all about keeping it real and showing up as my full self and accepting myself completely as I am. And that's something I've always struggled with my whole entire life, is looking into the mirror and thinking that I was a beautiful girl, thinking that I was worthy of love, believing that I was worthy of just genuine healthy connection for myself, and I never believed I could find that or have that and develop that and fully look in the mirror into my face, which I've always struggled with, and say, you are beautiful and I love everything you've become. And that's why I wanted to shift this name into Keeping It Katrina, because I want everybody that I touch, every soul that I talk to, to show up and recognize that their beauty lies within the fact that no one else is them. And that's the most beautiful thing. So that's why I switched in this name. And again, it's a play on keeping it real. So you know I'm gonna bring just my full authentic self with you guys and always be open and honest about my mental health struggles. I'm really excited to open up more about my relationship with Dylan, especially from going, as you've been following me for a while, from toxic relationship to trying to build a healthy relationship with my partner, my friends, my family, as it really impacted my family relationship as well as myself. So I can't wait to share that with you on this channel. And as I said, I just cannot wait to show up for you guys as a friend here. And I hope you come to this channel every single week, and I hope you feel that love, and I hope you feel like you have a friend on your side. I'm gonna let you know every single week that no one is you and that is your power, and I can't wait to show up for you. But we got a lot of stuff to do today, so we are gonna go to the farmer's market, and we're also gonna run through a full workout, so let's go.
Katrina?
Yeah?
Where are we going?
Farmer's market. Farmer's markets are my favorite place ever in the world, and they are my first dates I started taking myself on.
Oh, so you're going on dates without me. We just gotta live in the
moment, blow your Monday, let's just go. Happy Mother's Day.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
When you have a chance, when you're all alone, I just want to have you in my time.
Yeah, Dylan, not allowed. Thinking we should get away, get away. Leave our troubles for another day, another day. I drink this, I don't know if you do this, Jeremy, but I drink honey like a mother. Like, if there's anything that's a staple in my diet, it's honey and chocolate. That's it. That's it. But anyway, so pre-workout meal, we're getting ready to hit a sick-ass hamstring and glute day. But my pre-workout meal, we have a little spring roll bowl. So how cute is this in the little mason jar? But it's just rice noodles. We have actually, it's ground turkey. It's supposed to be chicken. But it's ground turkey, and I seasoned it with garlic, ginger, and soy sauce. And then you just top it with veggies, sesame seeds, and you mix it all together. And I also just warmed up a coffee because I made it earlier and I didn't drink it yet. But all I do with my coffee is I add a little collagen, a little almond milk, and then I do a little bit of honey. So it's like a little healthy hormone latte. But that's gonna be my little pre-workout for the day. Two things you always wanna prioritize for your pre-workout meal. Protein and carbohydrates. Then you want to add a little bit of healthy fats in there as well. Make sure you're having that balanced plate. And I'm about to dig in. Oh, it's been sitting in the fridge a little too long. Got a little frozen. All right, this is the mood, honestly, for life, not just for the day. This is the fucking mood for life. We gotta get the vibe. Okay, I don't know if you guys like this, but I'll find a song and it's so good. And it's the only song I listen to on repeat throughout my whole workout. Two workouts later, I can't fucking stand it. So then I'm consistently just going through a top song every single week. My whole playlist I just hate at this point. But I just remembered my old playlist looking like a meal from college. You haven't listened to it. It just has all the vibes. So I honestly think, let me know if I'm wrong. I'm gonna say 2015, 2018 was one of the most iconic eras. Well, obviously, and then we have to throw it back, the old Akon. Look back and watch me smack that hat all on. Oh my gosh, like 2005, 2010. That was some good shit too. I can't show them what I've been recently listening to because it's gonna hit the next launch video. Someone made the same playlist and look at the fucking. That's all I hope to be. Excuse my charisma. This is one of the best songs of all time. This gets me on my shit every single time. The key for a good lift. Good dude, a great ass song, and just find something to get pissed off at.
It's leg day, get your ass up.
Oh.
He said no. Someone asked me, they were like, does Toulouse ever walk? Luce, do you want to show him your walk?
All right, welcome to our home gym. This is how I enter the gym. So our biggest requirement for renting a house was to have a basement so Dylan could build his dream home gym. And I'm not taking credit for any of this. He did the whole thing, planned it out, measured everything, built it. So this is him. But let's walk through it and show you guys, because we're gonna be filming a lot of SculptU stuff here, YouTube stuff. We have a lat pull down, we have a squat rack, bench, two barbells, a cable machine. We have the weight treat, and we have all the dumbbells. I don't know who's gonna be like, actually, I can do these for lower body. Good for me. And then, my favorite machine ever, Pit Shark. I love how it takes the load off your upper back, focus on the legs. And let's hit this lift. Texas, so excuse my grandma, big booty, my standards, Deuce and Fanta. If I'm in the scene, I'm flexing in the camera. Check my fellas, we all flock the same. We birds of the same feather, we together, this forever. Switching bezels every level. Me and Cinco push that two dope coupe. Ain't none of this shit rented, serving fishes. Fuck your favorite rapper. Hope you get a. Alright, Coach Chalice is gonna put me through. He looks so pissed. He's like, I fucking hate it. Look at that freaking rump on him though. He knows what he's talking about, so don't let anyone give you shit loose. Anyway, we're gonna be running through a hamstring glute focused leg day. We're gonna start off with lying leg curls, and I'm gonna need this bench, so let's move it, coach. All right, so if you're doing hamstring curls at home, this is exactly how I program it for my at-home program. You're gonna put your dumbbell on the ground. You're gonna place your feet at the top of the dumbbell. You can do this on the floor, I'm doing it on the bench. You're gonna come forward, grip the top of the dumbbell, and come up. My coach isn't the best, honestly. He's always in the... This is impacting my core strength to lose, okay. And then we're gonna come in,
We're gonna make sure we're moving that neutral spine. Core is braced. Bring it up. Come down. These fucking suck. Don't underestimate these mamma jammas for real. Does anyone else after like the fifth rep, they're like, I'm good? Especially on squats. After the fifth rep, I'm good. Okay, ass and fucking face.
Have you ever seen those like salts that like get your like jacked up?
Yeah.
So this is ass, we'll do that to you for real. All right, next movement is RDL. Let's walk through the top things. Now, an RDL is not a bend over to the ground. It's head, shoulders, knees, and no. Pretend that shit's your ex-boyfriend, we're avoiding it. So it's not a bend over, it's a hinge at your hips. Now, next tip, the straighter we have our legs and knees, the more hamstrings we're gonna target. So in order to target more glutes, we're gonna have a slight bend in your knees, take that stretch off the hamstrings, put more of a stretch into the glutes. Next thing with an RDL, the range of motion plays a big factor here. So many people's range of motion isn't all the way to the floor because you see I'm putting stress on my low back. So we're gonna come down, hinge, keep the weight as close to our body as possible. For many people, we're still maintaining a neutral spine and still maintains that tension in our glutes is right below our knees. Now we're gonna pull up with our glutes, and I'm talking. I want you to pretend like someone's about to come in with a finger in your butt and you're like, mm-mm. So squeeze your cheeks like, mm-mm. Pull it up. All right, let's go ahead and start it off. All right, we just finished our last set of RDLs. And I have something to preach to you guys today. Every single time that you make a decision for the person that you want to be, your future self is thanking you. And it is so powerful to view habits that way and to view habits in who do I want to be and who am I doing this for? Let's go to the next step. All right, next movement, a drop lunge. So we're going to elevate our front foot. It's going to allow us to get a deep stretch in that glute. So how we make a lunge more glute biased. So the more knee flexion we have, so if we're coming forward into our lunge, standing up straight, you can see I'm coming deep into that lunge. We're going to target our quad more. Now to minimize that knee flexion, we're going to hinge at our hips and we're going to sit back into our glute. You can see here and here. So I'm gonna hinge and sit back and get that stretch in my glute. So get that ass up right now, and I want you to try this out. You're going forward in your lunge or hinging and sitting into it. Let's hit the set. Unilateral movements are incredible. You want to always make sure you're incorporating unilateral movements, but especially if you feel like one cheek is bigger than the other, you're stronger on the other side, there's an imbalance, etc. So let's get into this one. Okay. So with the single leg assisted RDL, one foot's back. We're going to do the same thing, slight bend at the knee. You're going to go all the way back. Back is still flat. We're going to squeeze our glutes, pull back up. This is such a good, because you really get to focus primarily on that leg. So for a lot of us, one leg seems to take over in movement. So this is such a great movement to incorporate. You know what's the worst, honestly? The worst thing, though, with a unilateral movement, especially split squats, like, I'm like, I don't have the freaking capacity to do the other leg. Like, the first leg was good, right? I'm just trying to have one cheek be blown up, and I'm just gonna use that side for everything. You can just talk to me on that side. Last movement, we have a back extension. If you don't have a back extension machine, this is a great alternative. I also really like using the leg curl machine. But what you're gonna do is you're gonna set up your Smith machine or a barbell. You're gonna put a pad here. And with any back extension that you're gonna do, you wanna make sure it lines up right at your hip. And we wanna make sure we're not arched like our other movements. So we're not, like I said, Nicki Minaj pointed out, we're tucking in our pelvis. And again, that floor is still your ex-boyfriend, bitch. We're avoiding it. So we are not diving down all the way into it for a glute bias back extension. So what we're gonna be doing, you're gonna wanna like, I'm talking, I want you to thrust against this pad, like, you know, you're getting some good, I can't say that, can I? Getting some good, but I want you to thrust against this, your feet slightly pointed out, your knees are gonna be slightly bent as well here. We're gonna have our knees slightly bent. Upper body a little bit rounded. We're gonna come down, not all the way down because that takes the stretch off of our glutes and focuses more on our back. So we're again keeping a lower range of motion. And again, I want you to, I know there's a lot of fingers going in the butt, but that's the best cue I found. Imagine the fingers going in your butt, squeeze, pull yourself up. And it will feel, I'm telling you, if you're doing this correctly, it will feel like you're pulling up just with your glutes. You will not feel your freaking back in this. It's just crazy. So
That's what we mean by glute bias back extension. And let's hit it. Me after leg day. But in all seriousness, great leg workout. Again, I program all my workouts on the Sculptu app. That was the intermediate and advanced gym workouts. I have home, all the stuff. But I need you to listen to me when I say, don't let anybody else, because I know a big factor from getting into the gym, posting fitness content, all the stuff is other people's opinions. Do not give a mother freak about what anyone else thinks. I need you to see your worth, and I need you to stand and fight for yourself, and I pretend I'm in your ear every day telling you that. All right, let's go eat dinner.
What do you think about leg racing?
Oh, he fucking can't stand it. He's like, this bitch just talks about no one else is you, and that's your power. Like, there's a lot of fucking great tabbies out there, bitch. But there's not. There's no one like this man. He's my soul kitty.
Dinner time.
Take 17.
All right, we're about to have a little family dinner. This is something I really want to instill in my future family, and all we have right now is Delta.
This is the direction you're taking right now? What? Talking about our future family?
Yeah.
Okay.
Me, the cats. You, and then everyone watching is my family, so. Welcome to our little family dinner. So we typically have a big Sunday dinner in this house. We typically have a big bowl of pasta, but we found some potatoes at the farmer's market. So we're gonna make those, a ribeye. We're gonna saute some veggies, and then I'm gonna make a big ass brownie afterwards, and I'll show you guys how to make it.
All right, now the real chef enters the kitchen.
I literally just let out gas because I laughed.
Basically, I always cook the steaks because I cook steaks well. I've done it for a really long time. I'll try to explain to you guys how I do it. It's probably not the most scientific way, but I'll just explain how I would get this steak to be
delicious.
Those
who don't know, I was a food science major, so I'm going to see if you're properly educated.
Well, how come I'm the one who has to cook the steaks then if you're a food science major?
You just do it well.
Okay, so basically, the only thing I would put on my steaks is just sea salt, and then also the only thing we're going to put on these potatoes is just gonna be sea salt and then a little bit of Old Bay seasoning.
Oh, I don't want the Old Bay.
Too bad. All right, I'm putting Old Bay on after. I recommend you guys do it. And then also we're gonna put this bone tallow, like the beef
which
tallow.
Which we've never had.
Which we've never actually
had.
We
got it at the farmer's market.
Got it at the farmer's market. Super healthy fat because it's from good quality sources. We love that. So yeah, I am going to, yeah, pretty much just salt the other side of this. Okay, right now. So yeah, I'm gonna salt the other side of the steak, which is very.
It feels like we're on a fucking.
Very interesting.
Obviously, this is my first YouTube video, and it feels like we're on.
Wow, your cookies are small.
I don't know. Yeah, I want to cook fast. I'm hungry.
Sheesh.
If anyone's seen Top Chef, that's our favorite cooking show of all time, by far.
You have to spin.
Oh my god! You know what we've always wanted to do? Let me know if you're interested in this. I've always wanted to do a chop video.
What,
like, where basically you give me a basket and I give you a basket of random ingredients. Remember Chop, the show?
So I can literally give you like a thing of like
beef. And I have to make a meal out of it.
Like beef testicle.
Oh, I know you like that.
Okay. Anyways, the other thing is I like to keep my steak, I like to get it to room temperature, let it sit out of the fridge for like an hour before you cook it, because this actually lets the whole steak get to room temperature so that the inside of the steak is not like significantly colder, and then it'll actually cook better and more evenly. Also, like the way that I like to do this is just put all these peppers, mushrooms into the same pan that you cook the steak in, and kind of let like the fat from the steak marinate all the veggies and that you're gonna cook. And so, yeah, that's pretty much how we're gonna be cooking this meal. It's a very simple meal. Obviously, pretty much anyone can do this easily and pretty quickly if you have like, you know, a little bit of time. So
you're like on a whole ass chef show.
I am. I mean, I'm a YouTuber. I used to be a YouTuber, a retired YouTuber.
This is so cute. We actually haven't eaten outside yet. So this is really special.
Yeah, we literally haven't eaten out here once.
Dylan actually set all this up tonight, so thank you.
We got our potatoes, we got our steak and veggies.
Are we bringing the cats out?
Some grapefruit. No, because then we'll be stressed that they're gonna run away. Jumping off the porch like mom's not home.
Tell me why the best things feel so wrong. One thing my mom taught me, chocolate is an everyday staple. So I always end the night with chocolate. Dylan can confirm, no matter what, I'm getting that fucking chocolate.
Confirmed.
In. Doesn't matter if we get home at 2 a.m., 3 a.m., I'm getting the.
Which never happens, actually.
I'm getting the chocolate in. So I'm making a little collagen protein brownie. I'm gonna put the recipe on the screen so
Okay, yeah, so the recipe will be somewhere right here.
Right there?
No, not right there, right there.
Oh, right there, okay. It's basically taking a real brownie recipe and just putting it into a cup. It's so good. I honestly am just going off my fucking head.
This might be really bad.
I'm trying to remember.
Oh. You're just jerry-rigging it.
I am just saying.
Winston. Okay. No. Oh, hey, Winston. Marie McKenna Wright. Get off. Marie. This is bad behavior, Marie. What do you need to do? Marie. Down. There you go. There you go.
I microwave it for 30 seconds, keep it ooey gooey. And then, you know, you can never have, does it look nice? Does it look good?
Here, show.
You can never have enough chocolate, so I always put more chocolate on top and then have that melt on top, and then it just oozes into it. It's just amazing, so.
The end result.
It's so good. I hope you guys enjoyed my first YouTube video. I'm sure I'll get better with time, better with age. Yeah, I'm so excited to keep continuing growing. There's always a cat fucking around in the background. You'll notice that soon, but I'm so excited just to continue to show you more myself, my life, connect with you guys more, and just be a friend for you. So cheers to that. Off the porch like mom's not home.